Welcome back, everyone. This is Travis here, Fish of Hex. Appreciate you stopping in. Today's video is going to be pretty quick, but I wanted to show you the whole process of adding an airline for the Nios Quantum 300 protein skimmer that I currently have on the frag system. Now, one quick note about that skimmer. It is for the 300-gallon build, and I will be putting the Curve 7 back onto the frag tank once that build has started. Now, this airline will both work for the frag system and the 300-gallon build. I will just add a T or a Y connector or something like that to this airline. Allow me to connect it to the other skimmer on the system. So regardless, guys, these are the basic parts I picked up from Home Depot, some cable clips, the 1/2-inch tubing that you guys just saw up on the screen, and then, of course, and a coupling, because I didn't have enough tubing. They didn't make it long enough to go exactly where I needed it to, but what's good is I had a lot of extra tubing, so I'm just going to use the extra for the attachment to the 300-gallon build. So what you're looking at here is the original airline I put on there once I moved. It's actually my auto top-off hose that I just ran outside just to get some kind of fresh air in, because once I moved the system, I noticed that my pH was really low. It was actually about 7.6 to 7.8, and it kind of stayed around there. And I double-checked my alkalinity. It was at 9.5, which definitely means that I have too much CO2 in the system, not enough oxygen getting in there. All right, so basically, I knew I needed to do something immediately, so I just simply connected that hose that day and then took the next day to go ahead and add this airline. Now, when it comes to installing this hose, I got pretty lucky because it fits just underneath the door. There's like this little foam padding there, and you can't even tell that the hose is there for the exception of looking down and actually seeing it. But I got pretty lucky. I am happy that I didn't have to drill any holes or find another way to get it outside. And then at that point, I just went ahead and kind of punched it into the wall with those clips all the way around the room. Of course, had to put a couple holes in the cement. And then, like I mentioned before, the hose wasn't long enough and it stopped right before the refugium. So at that point, I went ahead and added the coupling and continued to run the hose to the Quantum 300 protein skimmer. Once I had the airline over to the skimmer, I went ahead and attached it to the inner leg of the stand just to keep it in place. I didn't have to worry about it moving around or anything. And then at that point, I just went ahead and connected to one of the two airlines on the skimmer. Now, with the way the skimmer works, it's obviously going to pull air from the path of least resistance, and you can't just turn off one of these air inlets. So basically what I had to do is go ahead and block one of them completely, allowing it to pull all the air it needs from that line itself. So what I did is I went ahead and took a piece of that hose and one of the frag plugs I made and just simply put the frag plug inside the hose. It was pretty snug, and then just put it over that other air input. Now, I definitely noticed a big difference in pH just on the temporary setup alone, even if it was only for 24 hours. It went from that 7.6 to at least 7.9, 7.95. It stayed around that. And then once I added this airline, there was a big jump. It went up to 8.15, which was definitely good. And my alkalinity was just under 9.5 at that point. And that's kind of where I like to keep everything. So I'm happy with those numbers. That's definitely better than 7.6. And the corals started opening up immediately. And I could just tell that everything in the tank was doing much better now that the pH was in a good range. Well, guys, that's about it for this video. I wanted to keep it as quick as I possibly could and just get right to the point. So if you guys are struggling with pH or have any issues like that, I definitely recommend you try this method. It's a really good way to bring in oxygen into your system. And if you guys are still struggling with that, go ahead and check out my pH video. I'll find the link and put it in the description below for you. And that definitely goes into detail on some of the other things you can do to increase your pH in your reef tank. Either way, guys, I hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you next time. Peace.